Good afternoon, students. In the previous class, we have completed chemical properties of alkanes. Okay, totally we have seen what are the chemical properties for alkanes, how they will undergo reactions. All these things we have seen. In today's class, we will go through next concept present in alkanes only, that is called conformers. Conformations, conformations. Okay, first, what is the definition of this? Definition means what is meant by conformations. After that, how we are going to study these things. Okay, everything we will know. For example, I am considering one alkane, that is ethane, and I am going to explain what are these conformations, all these things. Is it okay, ma'am? We will see. By considering the ethane, what is the formula of ethane? Ethane formula is C2H6. Let us see the formula of ethane, C2H6. Okay. How we can write the C2H6 structure? Already I have shown for you that C2H6 structure is like this. Observe this carefully, all of you. This black colored ball, it is carbon. This is also carbon. Between carbon and carbon, we have single bond that is undergone by sp3 hybridization of first carbon. Hybrid orbital of first carbon undergoes overlapping with sp3 hybrid orbital of second carbon. Next, these white colored balls are hydrogens. These white colored balls are hydrogens. See, this is the structure of ethane. Is it correct, ma'am? Now, how we are going to explain this conformations topic by using this ethane molecule? Is it okay, ma'am? Now let us see the explanation, all of you. Carefully observe. First, I will start like this. Ethane. Front carbon. This is rear carbon, back carbon. Rear means R-E-A-R, ma'am. Okay, observe. For you, it is front. This is rare carbon. If you see like this, this is the structure of ethane. Okay, now this is one structure possible. I am rotating. Like this, I am rotating the one carbon. Because of that rotation, these hydrogens are rotating. Here my explanation is, between carbon and carbon, only one bond is present. If only one bond is present, rotation of carbon, any one carbon, is possible. If between carbon and carbon, if only one bond is present, rotation of the carbon is possible. Because of these rotations, we are getting multiple forms of ethane. Suppose like this we have, this is one form. If it is rotated like this, that is another form. If it is rotated like this, that is another form. Like that, because of this rotation, okay, because of this rotation like this, we are going to write the ethane molecular structure in different ways. But you need to observe that is, structure is not changed. This is tetrahedral carbon, this is also tetrahedral carbon. There is no change in structure. Okay. This carbon and this carbon is bonded by single bond only. This carbon and hydrogen is bonded by single bond. Everything is same only. But only the difference is, because of this presence of sigma bond, one bond, there is a rotation of one carbon or another carbon, any one will be possible around the internuclear axis. This is nucleus of carbon, this is also nucleus of carbon. Through that one axis is passing, imaginary axis, that is called internuclear axis. Inter means between, nuclear means nucleus. Between the nucleus, one line we can imagine, that is called internuclear axis. Okay, passing through that internuclear axis, around that this carbon can be rotating. Like this rotation is possible. Because of this rotation, this ethane molecule with same tetrahedral structure, both carbons tetrahedral structure, we can write with different forms. Suppose this is this hydrogen and this hydrogen backside present exactly. If you rotate like this, it is coming little bit angle, with a different angle it is coming. If you rotate like this further, furthermore angle is possible. Like that, throughout this axis, we can rotate one carbon because of presence of one bond. If two bonds are present, that rotation is not possible. That rotation is restricted. That one we will observe in alkenes. In alkenes, if double bond is present, carbon, there is no chance to be rotated like this. Because two bonds, they will lock the rotation of carbon. But here only one bond is present, na? So there is a chance of rotation of carbon around the internuclear axis. Because of this rotation, different forms of ethane we are getting, ma? But structure will not be changed, bonds will not be changed. Because of this rotation only, we are going to explain these forms. Those forms are called conformers. Different forms of ethane are possible because of the rotation of the bond around the internuclear axis. These are called conformers. Okay, and the process is also called as conformations. Conformers or conformations, both are same. Okay, man? Conformers or conformations, both are same. Now, slowly I am teaching because this is for understanding purpose or imaginary purpose, little bit time will be taken. Even though by taking this ball and stick model, I am able to explain. Okay, definitely you can understand. Once again, I will repeat this one. Observe all of you. I am going to take this ethane molecule, this black colored balls carbon. Between the carbon and carbon, one bond is present. As one bond is present, there is a chance of rotation of the carbon around the internuclear axis. Because of that rotation, previously hydrogens, if they are present like this, exactly back and back. This is front and this is back. Because of that rotation, slight angle is getting varied. One more time, if you rotate like that, slightly angles are getting varied. Is it okay? Because of that, different forms we are getting for ethane molecule with same structure, that is tetrahedral only, but there is no change in structure, man. Okay, the different forms are called conformers or conformations of ethane. This type of rotation is not possible in alkenes because alkenes contain double bond in which this carbon-carbon is locked by double bond. So there is no chance of rotation. Because of presence of double bond, there is no chance of rotation in alkenes. But in alkanes, it is possible. Is it okay, ma? Now, coming to this further explanation, okay, see. Exactly, hydrogen are backside. See, that is one form. Slightly I rotated. Slightly, two. Slightly, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Like that, how many forms with small rotation also we are going to say that is the form. Is it okay? Like that, it is possible to draw infinity number of conformers. infinity number of conformers. Slightly, see, exactly hydrogen, hydrogen back side. Okay, ma'am. Slightly, I see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, like that, with small rotation also. Here actually, slightly I rotated, na, that is also big rotation. With small 0.1 degrees, if you rotate also, that is considered as one form. Like that, how many points present on the circle, infinity points, na? So those infinity points touching that hydrogen, we can rotate. That means how many conformers are possible, infinity conformers are possible of ethane, for ethane. Are you understanding me, everyone? Infinity number of conformers are possible for ethane. But among this infinity number of conformers, only two are highly familiar. Infinity number of conformers, only two are highly familiar. Those are staggered form and eclipsed form. What are those? Staggered form and eclipsed form. These two are highly familiar when compared to other. Okay, ma'am? What are these two forms? We have to see them. After that, small terms are there. After seeing those terms, okay, two scientists gave the representations of these two forms. Those are eclipsed form and staggered form. Those two representations we will see, and we will complete this one. Okay, ma'am. Now, final one more time conclusion. Because of the rotation of the bond, different forms of ethane we are able to get. Okay, ma'am. How many forms are possible? Simply by rotating slight 0.1 degrees like the rotation also, we are able to tell that is one form. Like that, infinity terms, infinity forms are possible because of this carbon rotation. Why this carbon is rotating? Because of presence of one bond present between carbon and carbon. There is a rotation possible between carbon and carbon. If double bond is present, that rotation is not at all possible. If double bond is present, that rotation is not at all possible. In alkenes, this rotation is not at all possible. Okay, ma'am. Now, everyone, by rotating slightly also, one form we are going to get. Like that, infinity number of forms we can draw for ethane molecule. Those forms are called conformers or conformations. Those forms are called conformers or conformations. Okay. Out of these many infinity number of conformers or conformations, two are very familiar. Those two are called are staggered form and eclipsed form. All the infinity forms we cannot discuss. So out of these infinity forms also, okay, two forms are very familiar for ethane molecule. Those two are staggered form and eclipsed form. Okay, those two forms, I will say in what way they are present. Okay, ma'am. And among these two also, I have to discuss which one is more stable and which one is less stable. All those things I will discuss. Before that, till now, what is the concept? It is explained. I hope you are understanding this one. Is it okay, ma'am? Okay, let us see. What about the staggered form and eclipsed form? Okay, ma'am? Okay, see all of you. Exactly, these two hydrogens are coinciding. If you see from like this one, we can see only one hydrogen, front. Rare hydrogen, it is not at all possible to see. Like that, one form is possible. That possible form is called eclipsed form. This form is called eclipsed form. Exactly, front hydrogen, rare hydrogen. Rare means back, ma, are exactly coinciding. That is called eclipsed form. all the hydrogens we are able to see clearly. See, like a star it will be. This is front carbon, this is rear carbon. Three hydrogens. Exactly in between these two, this is middle. This form is called staggered form. This form is called eclipsed form. These two are very familiar. See, slowly I am rotating. Starting eclipsed form, I am rotating like this, and I got staggered form. Next, again if I rotate, again I will get eclipsed form. Again if I rotate, staggered form. Like that, staggered form, eclipsed form are very familiar out of infinity number of forms for ethane. Okay? I hope you are clear how staggered form and eclipsed form are present. Is it okay, ma? Now, coming to this explanation, eclipsed form contains hydrogens exactly nearby each other, back and back. Hydrogen atoms are closer to each other. When they are closer to each other, repulsions are high. When repulsions are high, molecule is less stable. That's why eclipsed form is less stable when compared to staggered form. Eclipsed form is less stable when compared to staggered form. In staggered form, hydrogens are very far away. Angle is very high. When compared to eclipsed form, in staggered form, these hydrogens are very free. See, ma? Like this, they are present. From front side, if you see, these two are also, we are able to see. Means, between this one and this one, distance is high. Because of that, repulsions will be reduced. Okay. When repulsions are reduced, molecule is getting stable. So, out of eclipsed form and staggered form, which is more stable? Staggered form is more stable. Eclipsed form is less stable. Staggered form is more stable. Eclipsed form is less stable. Okay. How to represent the staggered form and eclipsed form? Two projections are there. That one I will show later. First, did you understand everyone? What is the staggered form and what is that eclipsed form? Is it okay, ma? Everyone? Now, next thing. Generally, this ethane molecule is stable in which form? Staggered form. Why? These hydrogens are far away from each other, na? This is the exact staggered form, na? Okay, these hydrogens are far away from each other, na? That's why this is stable form. But if you give any form of energy from outside, if you give any form of energy from outside, by the absorption of that energy, this carbon will rotate and it will form eclipsed form also. By gaining energy. When energy is gained, its stability decreases. Okay. Then it will get eclipsed form. After some time, in this eclipsed form, this ethane molecule, it will find it is less stable. Then automatically again, it will lose the energy to form staggered form. While it is converting from staggered form to eclipsed form, it is going to absorb some energy as well as it is going to release some energy. When it is going to convert from eclipsed form to staggered form, it is going to lose the energy. When it is converting from staggered form to eclipsed form, it will gain energy from outside. By mistakenly, if you provide that one will be gained by staggered form and it will be converted to eclipsed form. Is it okay, ma? That amount of energy is the difference between staggered form and eclipsed form. That is approximately 20 kilojoules per mole. How much amount of energy? 20 kilojoules per mole. While staggered form is converted to eclipsed form, 20 kilojoules of energy, sorry, staggered form is converted to eclipsed form, 20 kilojoules per mole of energy will be absorbed. Because of that, stability decreases. When it has high energy one, stability will be less. Next, when eclipse form is converted to standard form, 20 kilojoules per mole of energy will be lost. Because of that, staggered form has lower energy when compared to eclipse form. The substance which has lower energy, it will be highly stable. That's why staggered form is highly stable when compared to eclipse form. Okay, ma'am? This is staggered form. We can say with the help of hydrogen cells. That 20 kilojoules per mole, all of you, I hope you understood. Okay, next. Next, observe the board, all of you, carefully. While this eclipse form is rotating and it is converting into staggered form. Again, while staggered form is getting rotating and converted to eclipse form, actually staggered form will not be converted to eclipse form easily. We have to give energy. That energy will be absorbed and it will be converted to eclipse form. Otherwise it won't, because it is stable. Normally we won't stand. If you think, standing is the punishment. Why? It requires more amount of energy. That's why only you are feeling that it is the punishment. Legs will be pained, all these things. In that position, we will have to consume more amount of energy. Automatically, we will feel pains. So, whenever there is a chance, we want to sit down. Correct? We want to be stable. By that, we want to lower our energy. Every time, we want to be stable. Is it correct, ma? So, we want to sit there. Like that here also, whenever there is a chance, that molecule will be stable in eclipse form. That molecule is stable in staggered form. When we give energy, when we force, when any teacher forces you, then only you want to stand. Otherwise, no chance. Is it correct, ma'am? Like that, when we are giving energy from outside, then only that staggered form is converted to eclipse form. Finally, the conclusion is staggered form is highly stable when compared to eclipse form. That is okay. When this is getting rotated, because of that rotation, some strain will be generated. Because of that rotation, suppose when we are squeezing the cloth, we are rotating like that, definitely some opposition force will be generated. Is it correct, ma? Like that here also, when that bond is getting rotated, some small force will be generated. That is called torsional strain. That is called torsional strain. When we are rotating this one form to another form, we are getting some difference in angle. That angle is called dihedral angle. When we are rotating from one form to another form, we are getting some difference in angle. See, this is exactly both are coinciding, 0 degrees. If you see this one, definitely some 60 degrees will be there. The difference in angle is called dihedral angle. From one form to another form, they are differentiated with some angle. That angle is called dihedral angle. When that bond is getting rotated, it is developed by some strain, means some force. That is called torsional strain. Next, when one form is converted to another form, some amount of energy will be gained or lost. That is the energy 20 kilojoules per mole. Is it okay, ma? What is that energy? 20 kilojoules per mole. Next. Totally, I told infinity number of conformers present for ethane. Out of the two are familiar. Remaining all conformers are called skew conformers or skew conformations. Out of infinity, only two are familiar. Remaining all are called skew conformations. These things, while I am telling, you can note down. Dihedral angle, torsional strain. Okay, ma'am. That energy barrier, 20 kilojoules per mole. when staggered form crosses the energy barrier, that means 20 kilojoules per mole. If it gets the 20 kilojoules per mole, then only it will be converted to eclipsed form. Then eclipsed form, if it loses that much amount of energy, 20 kilojoules per mole, then only it is converted to staggered form. Is it okay, ma'am? That is energy barrier, energy which is interrelated. Okay, next, skew conformations, torsional strain, dihedral angle. While one form is getting converted to another form, some angle is getting deferred. That angle is called dihedral angle. Okay, ma'am? These are the terms which are useful in conformations or conformers of ethane. Out of staggered form and out of staggered form and eclipsed form, which is more stable? Staggered form is more stable. Okay, ma'am. Now, two scientists, they proposed how to show the staggered form and eclipsed form. Those two scientists are Newman and Sahors. Those two representations we will see and we will complete this one. Okay, ma'am. Just note down till now what it is explained, all of you. Okay, ma'am. See, those two scientists gave some representations. Those representations I am going to show. That one first. Sahors representation or Sahors projection. Sahors projections. He represented this form. Actually, this is three-dimensional. We are going to draw on board. It is two-dimensional. That's why we are taking the help of these projections. No? Okay. See. This is first friend carbon, this is rare carbon, they are bonded with single bond like this. See, this one and this one exactly coincided. This is friend carbon, actually this is like this one. Like this, front carbon, back carbon. Okay, on board it is not possible to show three dimensional. That's why I am showing like this, light angle with slight angle. Okay, ma'am. This is front carbon. This is rear carbon. Exactly coincided, na? This is called eclipse form. This is called eclipse form. Next. This is friend rare carbon, this is friend carbon. See, if you see, this hydrogen is in between these two. This hydrogen is in between these two. Okay, ma'am. This representation so shows staggered form. These two representations, eclipsed form and staggered form, with the help of Sahors. This is Sahors projection. Note down all of you, Sahors projections. After this, we are going through Newman's projections. Newman's projections, friend carbon he imagined it as circle, rare carbon, back carbon he imagined it as dot. This is friend carbon, this is rare carbon. Okay, now eclipse form I am going to show. both are exactly coincided. Both are exactly coincided. But the difference is, if you see this structure, ma, exactly, are you able to see backside hydrogens? Backside carbon, everything we are not able to see, na? Like that, this one also, Newman. First, front carbon with circle, rear carbon with dot, he has shown. So, exactly like this. If both hydrogens, front hydrogen and rear hydrogen, is exactly coincided, like this, ma. Anything, okay, exactly coincided, that is called eclipsed form. It is showing exactly eclipsed form. So I am writing here, this is eclipsed. What about the staggered form? Same, front carbon, rear carbon. Rear carbon three hydrogens will be like this. Front carbon three hydrogens will be like this. Or otherwise, we will do one thing. Circle with one dot. These hydrogens will be like this. These hydrogens will be like this. We can see exactly. Is it okay, ma? This is called staggered form. What are the representations? Newman's projections. I hope you understood by seeing the structure directly like this by using ball and stick model. Okay, ma? In this one, exactly these two hydrogens are coincided like this. This is called eclipsed form. This is rotated and like this. This is called staggered form. This is about conformations of ethane. I hope you are clear, everyone. Okay, so many conformations are possible for ethane. Out of that, two are very familiar. Those are staggered form and eclipsed form. Okay, in between staggered and eclipsed form, so many conformations are possible. Okay, ma. But we are not going to discuss all these things. Completely, we are depending on only two forms. In these two forms, which is highly stable, staggered form, because hydrogens are far away from each other, repulsions are less. When repulsions are more, energy will be high. So the molecule will not be stable. In hybridization also we have seen, the molecules will be coming into the shape automatically with less repulsions. Like that here also. Okay, ma? So staggered form is more stable when compared to eclipsed form. Those are shown with the help of two scientist projections. Those are Sahow's projections and Newman's projections. We have seen already Sahow's projections, ma. Now we are seeing Newman's projections. Okay, the torsional angle, sorry, dihedral angle is also called torsional angle. By this, alkane's topic is completed. Sorry, physical properties are there. The physical properties also I will discuss now. After that, we are going to complete the alkanes. Is it okay, ma? So in this alkanes topic, what are the topics, subtopics we have seen? Preparations of, before that, IUPAC nomenclature, isomerism. After that, preparations of alkanes. After that, chemical properties. These conformations. Okay, ma? After these conformations, we have to see that what are those physical properties. The physical properties theory part only. I will open the textbook and I will see that one. Let us see. Alkanes are almost non-polar molecules. I hope you know what is meant by non-polar molecule and what is meant by polar molecule. In chemical bond we have seen. Between carbon and hydrogen in alkanes, or alkenes are alkanes, electronegative difference is not there. Because of that, it is completely non-polar. If electronegative difference is there, that is polar molecule. Okay, ma? Now, alkanes are almost non-polar molecules. Because of the covalent nature of CC and CH bonds, and due to very little difference of electronegative difference between carbon and hydrogen atoms, they possess weak Van der Waals forces. This weak Van der Waals forces information it will be explained in alkene's topic next. That one only I will explain. Okay, ma'am. At that time, you will be more clear. Weak van der Waals forces means weakest forces. Those are present between molecule and molecule. Those are intermolecular forces. Okay. Due to the weak forces, the first four members C1 to C4 are gases. When the forces are weak, they are present as gases. Little bit when carbon atoms are increased, ma, those forces will be increased, and C5 to C10 like that, they are exist as liquids. C10 greater than C10, they are present as solids. See, C1 to C4, that means methane, ethane, propane and butane, these are all gases. C5 to C17, not C10, C17 are liquids. And those containing 18 carbon atoms or more, 18 carbon atoms or more, are solids at 298 Kelvin. Okay, they are colorless and odorless. No color is there, as well as no odor. What do you think about solubility of alkanes in water? Water is polar solvent, ma. Alkanes are non-polar. Non-polar will not be soluble in polar. Polar will be soluble in polar. Non-polar will be soluble in non-polar. For example, naphthalene balls are there. Naphthalene balls, if you keep it in water, they won't be soluble. But if you keep it in kerosene, it will be soluble, because naphthalene balls are non-polar. Okay, ma. Next, kerosene is non-polar. So non-polar substances will be soluble in non-polar substances only. Polar substances will be soluble in polar substances. Salts are there, NaCl, it is polar. Plus charge and negative charge are there. Polar means charges, ma. Okay. They are dissolved in water. NaCl, MgCl2, KCl. These are all soluble in water. Is it okay, ma? Next. Petrol is a mixture of hydrocarbons and is used as a fuel for automobiles. Petrol and lower fractions of petroleum are also used for dry cleaning of cloths to remove grease stains. Grease stains are non-polar in nature. So in dry cleaning industry, they are going to use petrol to remove the stains. Because in homes, we will use water. Water cannot be soluble, those grease stains cannot be soluble in water, they cannot be removed easily. That's why if you go to dry cleaning industries, they can remove that grease stains easily, because grease stains are non-polar in nature, petrol is also non-polar in nature. Okay, on the basis of this observation, what do you think about the nature of the greasy substance? You are correct. If you say that grease mixture of higher alkanes is non-polar and hence hydrophobic. Hydrophobic, phobia means hate, hydro means water. Water hating. The substance which is not soluble in water, that is water hating. The substance which will be soluble in water, that is water attraction, hydrophilic. Hydro means water, philic means attraction. Phobia means fear. Hydrophobic means it is going to hate the water. Okay, it is generally observed that in relation to solubility of substances in solvents, polar substances are soluble in polar solvents, non-polar substances are soluble in non-polar solvents. Light dissolves light. Okay. Boiling point of different alkanes are given table 13.2. Once observe them, when molecular weight is increased, automatically intermolecular forces increases. Then boiling points also increase. Boiling point means easily it cannot be converted to gaseous state or liquid state. Liquid state means freezing point. Melting point. High boiling point and high melting point substances cannot be converted from one form to another form because they have strong attractions. Okay, this clarity, little bit more clarity, I will give in alkene's topic. Next I am going to teach for you. Okay, next. You can make an interesting observation by having a look on the boiling points of three isomeric pentanes. Okay, ma? This paragraph, one paragraph alone, boiling points topic, after completion of alkenes attractions, different types of intermolecular attractions I will teach, ma. After that, once again I will come to this para. At that time it will be more clear for you. So between one molecule and one molecule, what are the different types of intermolecular attractions present? Those intermolecular attractions, everything I will discuss. After that, I will go to alkenes topic. Okay? After discussion of them, if I come to this topic again, it will be more clear for you. Okay, ma'am? This is the topic remained in alkenes, boiling points. So by this, remaining full, every concept present in alkenes, it is completed. Okay? Before going to alkenes, some basic terms are required for alkenes topic. Those topics I will complete and we will enter into the alkenes. Is it okay, ma'am? That is about today's class. In today's class, we have seen conformations of ethane. Okay, different types of conformations and how they are shown by using different projections. All these things I have taught for you. I hope everyone, you are clear about the today's concept, ma'am. Okay. Thank you. Have a nice day. If you have any doubts, immediately you can contact me. No problem, I will solve your problems. Okay, ma'am. Thank you all. Have a nice day.